civil exchange, and so I think we're going to have a wonderful afternoon here, and we're proud and honored to host this debate. Today's a chance for the candidates for the 4th Congressional District seat to educate us about their position, their values, and their priorities for the next 2 years. And so I'd like to welcome from left to right, spatially, Earl Sholley.
Like Russian roulette, Mr. Frank allowed this game to be played and investors, Mr. Frank's buddies, many of them, snapped up discounted mortgages like hotcakes. Ordinary men and women, however, plumbers, teachers, MBTA drivers did not play in this game. But it is to these ordinary people that Mr. Frank has designated to pick up the tab of these failed investments. Then, an even more astounding development, and with no constitutional authorization, Mr. Frank made the recommendation, as reported in the March 28, 2008 Boston Globe, that Congress should allow a foreign global investment firm to regulate this nation's Security Exchange Commission and harmonize its regulations with foreign regulations overseas. If Congressman Frank wants to hand over his job of regulating the SEC over to a foreign investment company, clearly he no longer wants his job. Thank you.
All right, our next statement will be from Earl.
Good afternoon. I want to thank Tom and Wellesley colleagues for hosting this very important debate. My name is Henry Sholley. I'm a Republican candidate in the 4th Congressional District. I believe in less government, fewer taxes, and term limits. I think that we need to find common sense solutions to our many problems that we have today. I also believe that we should be looking at America first, that we are all Americans first before we are Republicans, Democrats, or independents. I believe we should get back to the concept of citizen legislator, which was the original intent of our founding fathers. I think that we should have individuals who give true public service for the public good in the community, state, and in our country. I think, unfortunately, what we've evolved into is a professional class of career politicians who are more concerned about partisan politics and pettiness and personal enrichment. I have many life's experiences. I won't go into them now. We'll be passing out some push cards later on, and you can read all about it. But this is a very important debate. I don't believe that my opponent represents the values or priorities of the voters in the 4th Congressional District. He is the chief architect of the mortgage meltdown. Now he seems to be going around the country on this magical excuse tour. I believe that the voters want truth and accountability. As my mother always says, there's nothing worse than a liar. The people want answers and they want it now. All of this is well documented that Mr. Frank is the key player. In fact, recently, the former president, Bill Clinton, made the statement on ABC News that when he was in the White House, he and the Republicans tried to reform Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. And every time they attempted to do so, the Democrats blocked their efforts. Mr. Frank, you and Fannie and Freddie encouraged and even forced lenders to give very bad mortgages because you knew that Fannie and Freddie would buy them. They were then sold to other financial institutions around the world, the good with the bad. They were bought by others because they were considered safe, because they had the government's implied backing. Mr. Frank, you even allowed them to give mortgages to welfare recipients and illegal immigrants. People got greedy and the greed started at Fannie and Freddie Mac. You became the affordable housing sugar daddy. They were protected by those who received the most donations and campaign contributions, including you, Congressman. Sir, at the very least, you owe the American people an apology and an explanation.
All right, thank you.